Welcome back to my channel. This is Jen, and in today's video, I'm going to be answering a question from my Facebook group. This morning, April, who is a marketing and operations manager at a chiropractor's office in Florida, posted a note. She said, "Jen, what do you do when anonymous customer surveys give you 7 or greater stars out of 10 on the question, would you refer people, but they aren't referring?" I'm going to tell you in this video the 7 keys to creating a referral marketing campaign to put your referrals on autopilot.
Your business is about to be richer.
All right, April, thanks so much for inspiring this week's video about referral marketing campaigns. This is really an important topic because if you run a service-based business where you're seeing a high volume of people, maybe you've got patients like the chiropractor does, or customers that are high value to you, referrals are a great way to build your business, obviously. Yes, word of mouth marketing and referrals is always a preferred way to build your business. But how do you create marketing campaigns to make asking for referrals and getting referrals much easier? How do you turn these raving reviews into actual new paying clients? So the secret is to create a referral marketing campaign. Now, there are 7 keys to turning a referral marketing campaign into an effective marketing strategy. I used this strategy very recently with one of my clients who is a metal roof builder here in Colorado Springs. And what we did was every time they have a new roofing client, they create a referral marketing campaign for the neighbors that are on the same street as their metal roofing client. So it's basically a sales letter that says, "Hey, we're in your neighborhood. We want to see you. Your neighbors down the street have trusted us to build their brand new metal roof, and here's why you should trust us too." And they go into the sales letter using the 7 elements that I'm about to share with you. So this could work for you no matter what you're selling, as long as you want more referrals in your business. The first key is to create it as a campaign. Don't rely just on hope that your clients, just because they love you, just don't rely on hope as a strategy. Hope is not a strategy. What I'm recommending is a printed and mailed piece that you would send to your customer base, your client base, or your patient base, or you would hand deliver it in the case of my metal roofing client. They're actually going to hand deliver the sales letters and put them in the doors of the people that are on the street as their new roofing client. But let's pretend like you are the chiropractor and you have patients that are really happy with your services and you want to get more patients like them. So I would create a mailing piece positioned as a gift from one of your other patients. So you could give your patients that are really happy with your services, your, let's say your 8, 9, and 10 rated patients, you could give them 3 sales letters that are already printed out that they could give to their friends, and it's positioned as a gift from them. There's actually a place on the sales letter or on the card that says a very special gift from Sue Adams. This makes it custom to your patient who you're asking to give you referrals, and it makes it have a much more perceived value. So in lieu of a name, you can also assign a customer code to that patient. So if Sue Adams doesn't want her name on the letter, or if it's just easier for you to figure this out, maybe with your computer system, you could actually just assign a customer code and then know that Sue Adams is customer code 012. And if a new patient referral comes in with customer code 012, it gets credited back to Sue. It's important that each letter is attributed to the patient or the client that is seeking out the referrals for you so that you can reward them. So if Sue Adams goes out and gets you 3 brand new patients, you want to show a token of appreciation to Sue. Maybe you give Sue a $25 gift card to her favorite restaurant or to Starbucks or to Amazon, or even a gift card that they can exchange in your practice for every single referral that she sends you. You'll just need a tracking system in place so that you can reward your customers, clients, or patients that go out and bring their friends to you. The second thing is to have an incentive or a gift that is in very large, bold type on the printed piece. with an assigned value. So when you give a gift to someone in marketing, it's important that you assign a value to it, because if it doesn't have a value, then it's not seen as valuable. I'll repeat that. If it doesn't have a value, it's not seen as valuable. So if your free gift is a free roofing inspection, their roofing inspections are valued at $347. So if we're gonna give a free roof inspection and a roof buyer's protection kit to everybody that's on the street as their client, we tell them that this free gift is valued at $347. In the case of the chiropractor, if you're going to give a free chiropractic adjustment valued at $110, make sure that you say you're giving the free chiropractic exam or adjustment valued at $110. This is really important, and make sure that it's big and bold on the piece and not hidden down in the fine copy. The third key is to make sure that there's an expiration date. So you'll want to just, this is basically like direct response marketing 101, is every time you make an offer, there has got to be an expiration date. So if it's, you know, call to book now, or call to book in the next 10 days, call to book in the next 14 days to take advantage of this special offer, that's really, really important. And because you should be asking your patients for a referral when they have a great interaction with you. So let's say your patient comes in, they have a great interaction with you, you ask them to rate their service and they give you 10 out of 10 stars, that's the time to hand them the referral letters and say, we're so glad that you had a great experience here. Here are these three letters that you can give as gifts to your neighbors or your friends or your coworkers. But make sure you do it now, because the gift expires in the next 14 days. That gives some sense of urgency, both to the person that you are asking to get you referrals and for the person that's getting the free gift. Okay, the fourth key in creating a referral campaign is to state the motivation of the gift. So why are you giving them a free roof inspection, or why are you giving them a free chiropractic adjustment? In the case of my metal roofer, we did the, because we're in your neighborhood, that was the reason. It can be very simple. It doesn't have to be complicated. Because we're in your neighborhood, we're here to give you a free roof inspection. Or because it's the holidays and we feel like celebrating. Or we just reached a milestone and all of our patients are rating us 8 out of 10 stars. Or we're looking for new patients just like you. Just make sure that there's some kind of reason why you're giving the free gift. The fifth most important thing to consider when creating a referral marketing campaign is to include the 3 or 4 most important advantages of them taking you up on your free gift. So if it's a free chiropractic adjustment, then make sure that you list out the 3 or 4 advantages to getting a chiropractic adjustment. The sixth and one of the most important components of a referral marketing campaign is to give very specific instructions on how they take you up on the call to offer. So if you want them to call your office, give them the phone number and state your hours of operation, ask for Denise, like be very, very specific. If you want them to fill out a form on your website, make sure that you don't just send them to the generic domain name of your website, but make sure that you send them to the domain name and the contact form URL address. All right, finally, a key component to a great referral campaign is to make sure that you include all of your business contact information, including your name, your business address, your company name, your phone number, your website address, your location, your hours of operation, all of the details that they are going to need in order to make taking you up on your offer and coming in as a new patient or a new client very, very easy. So I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you learned just one thing that's going to help you get more referrals in your business, and you learned something that's going to change the way that you do your marketing, make sure that you like this video, give it a thumbs up, make sure that you subscribe, and leave me a comment down below if you have any questions or comments about creating amazing referral campaigns in your business. Thanks so much for tuning in, and I'll see you on the next video.